We've missed you. It's just an energy in the house today, and we're going to worship God. We're going to get in His Word. It's Graduate Recognition Sunday, so I know, let's give them a hand, man. They made it. They made it through. And it's kind of like back when we used to take karate. When you got your black belt, they said, now you can start learning karate, all right? So you graduate high school, now you can start learning and start really getting into life. You have your basics down. Now on to the next level. We're going to celebrate that. We're going to give them some direction from God's Word this morning as we launch a study of the book of Daniel. Now typically, everything in me wants to say, turn and shake hands. But we're not going to do that today, all right? We're going to pray. And we're going to invite the Lord to just show up and to make Himself known in our house. In a formal setting, in a formal worship service, what is that part of the service called? The invocation. So we're going to invoke the name of our Lord over this gathering and invite Him to bless us with His presence. So let's do that together. Our Father, we know that the whole universe cannot contain You. You fill the earth. There's nowhere we can go as high as the heavens or as low as the deep from Your presence. But You choose to manifest Yourself and make Yourself known in special, unique ways. You said in Your Word that wherever two or more gather together in Your name, that You are there in the midst of them. So, Father, we invite You to make Yourself just awesomely known here today. To receive our praise as we, as one mass choir, sing to an audience of one. As we get into Your Word, enable me not only to preach it well, but Lord, enable us to hear it, receive it, and obey it. We ask You, O God, to change lives, save the lost, revive the saved, and may we walk out of here well fed on Your grace and Your Word. Now bless us through this time of worship. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated and give your attention to the screens.
All right, so we're going to take some time now and we're going to recognize our graduates. Let me first say, class of 2020, we are so proud of you. We are proud of you not only for what you've accomplished over the last number of years of your life, but we're also proud of you for how you've handled this last few months in your life. What an incredible opportunity for you guys to show the light of Christ through you and how you've handled this pandemic situation, and you've done so in a magnificently beautiful way, and we're just so proud of you. And so now we want to recognize you, we want to celebrate you, but we have to do it today in a little bit different way than we normally would. Normally we'd have like a processional, and they'd come down, we'd play music for them, and we'd all stand and clap for them and stuff, but we're doing it a little differently today, but nonetheless special and nonetheless important. So our first graduate that we want to recognize, and as our graduates are coming up, turn your attention to the screens and see a few memories of them as they were growing up. But our first graduate is TJ Cully. T.J. Cully, come on up, brother. T.J. graduated from Fernandina Beach High School, and his plans are next year to attend Trinity Baptist College, pursuing a bachelor degree right there in Jacksonville. Congratulations, T.J. We love you, brother. Our next graduate is Caleb Goltz. Caleb Goltz, he's making his own entry today. Caleb graduated from Fernandina Beach High School, and next year he plans to attend UNF to study finance. Congratulations, Caleb. Next we have Sarah Beth Lindbaum. Sarah Beth graduated Fernandina Beach High School, and next year Sarah Beth is attending FSU, and she's seeking to major in chemistry.
I want to congratulate the class of 2020, especially my sister, Sarah Beth. I'm really sorry that I can't be there for today, but I'm really proud of you, and I hope I can see you soon. Love you. I want to congratulate the class of 2020, especially my sister.
All right, and that's Sarah Beth's brother, Zach, who is serving our country, so he can't be here today. Very special for him to make that video. Our next graduate is Hannah Shields. Hannah also graduated from Fernandina Beach High School, and next year she plans to attend Valdosta State University. Congratulations, Hannah. Our next graduate is Ashley Thomas. Ashley also graduated from Fernandina Beach High School, and she plans to attend the University of Florida's Innovation Academy to study biology and eventually on a pre-med track. Congratulations, Ashley. Next, we have Carly Terry. Carly's also a graduate of Fernandina Beach High School, and next year she plans to attend the University of Florida, and she will major in advertising and minor in innovation. Congratulations, Carly. Next, we have Emily Vining. Emily also graduated from Fernandina Beach High School, and next year is planning to attend the University of Florida in the fall. Congratulations, Emily. And next we have Amelia Grace White. Amelia graduated from Fernandina Beach High School, and next year she plans to attend East Tennessee State University. Congratulations, Amelia. And now for our college graduates. First we have Brett Burnett. Brett graduated from the University of Florida, and he's pursuing a career in media and audiovisual production. Proud of you, Brett. Our next college graduate is Jeff Campbell. Jeff graduated from Campbell University. Trying to get away out of the way of our photographers here. And next year, he plans to go back to Campbell to pursue his MBA and also be a graduate assistant for the Campbell football team. Congratulations, Jeff. And finally, Jeff's sister, Lauren Campbell. Lauren graduated from Liberty University with a Master's of Arts in Marriage and Family Therapy. And she's getting married on June 7th and moving to Washington to work as a therapist. Congratulations, Lauren. Graduates, let me just take a moment real quick and give you a word of encouragement. There's a verse that is often attributed to graduates, and many times people will use this verse in a way that is useful and it's helpful, but not always exactly how the scripture intended it to be used. But I believe this year, this verse fits very fittingly. The verse is Jeremiah 29:11. You see, most people will use this verse to say, hey, God's got great plans for you. Your future's going to be amazing. Everything's going to be incredible. So don't worry about it. God's got it. But what they don't realize is that Jeremiah was writing these words during a time where his country was in unrest and his country was struggling. And they were having a very hard time. That's why Jeremiah is oftentimes referred to as the weeping prophet, because he spent many, many nights crying for his people and for his country. I tell you, over the last few months, many people have spent their nights crying for this country. Maybe you have spent many nights weeping over what you've lost this year. And many of us here in this room have wept with you. But let me encourage you with the words of the prophet in Jeremiah 29, and we'll start in verse 11. It says this, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. Then you will call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will hear you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart." And that is our encouragement to the class of 2020. No matter where you go, no matter what you do, seek the Lord with all your heart. Let's pray. Father, we come to you, and God, we pray a blessing upon these young people. We thank you for the bright futures that each and every one of us can see on their countenance and in their faces. God, as Pastor Zach is going to teach us and preach to us here in just a few moments about the countenance of Daniel's face and his friends and how it was brightened and he was emboldened for the future. God, we see a similar countenance here before us. God, we pray a prayer of blessing over them, a prayer of satisfaction in where you take them and how you lead them. And God, above all else, no matter where they go, who they do, what they do, or who they're with, God, we pray that they will seek your heart and seek you first in all that they do. We pray in your son Jesus' name, amen. Church, your class of 2020.